Hello everyone, Professor Franz here. Today we're going to talk about cross-price elasticity of demand. The definition is this: the percentage change in quantity demanded of good A divided by the percentage change of price of good B. Here is the bottom line. If you get a positive number for cross-price elasticity of demand, then the two goods are likely to be substitutes. If you get a negative number, then the goods are complements. If you get a zero, then likely the two goods are unrelated. Here is why. If you get a positive cross-price elasticity of demand, think about Coke and Pepsi. When the price of Coke goes up, then you don't buy Coke anymore, you buy more Pepsi. And therefore, the price of Coke and the quantity demanded for Pepsi are going in the same direction, and therefore you get a positive number. Moving on to complements. Suppose you consume peanut butter and jelly together, and the price of peanut butter goes up, so you don't buy peanut butter anymore, and you also buy less jelly. So you can see the price of peanut butter and the quantity of jelly you purchased are going in the opposite direction, and therefore you get a negative number for the cross-price elasticity of demand. Finally, you get a zero cross-price elasticity of demand for unrelated goods. So if the price of lip balm goes up, are you going to buy more or less green tea? It's not going to affect your purchase of green tea whether the price of lip balm goes up or down. And therefore, the percentage change in quantity demanded of green tea is equal to zero whether the price of lip balm goes up or down. And that's the reason why cross-price elasticity of demand is equal to zero for unrelated goods.